Hey Ross World, my money makes money. Credit class, part 5 of 7. Part 5 of 7. Credit mix. Credit mix, according to FICO, makes up 10% of your credit score. It makes up 10% of your credit score. You're like, credit mix, what are they talking about? We're talking about credit cards, mortgages, auto loans, student loans, etc. It makes up 10% of your credit score. This is how they compute things according to your credit report, because things are reported on your credit report, every single thing. And I said this in another video. Even if you think it's not on your credit report, it's probably on your credit report, right? There is a list of things that actually goes on your credit report. But nonetheless, just think that everything goes on your credit report and you'll be okay. Now, credit mix makes up 10% of your credit score according to FICO, the Fair Housing Corporation, right? On that 300 to 850 range to make up that credit score. But nonetheless, here's the thing. Credit cards, automobiles, medical loans, all those things show them a credit mix and how you are using it. Now, granted, some of you have 5 and 6, 7, 8 credit cards. You may be too aggressive in one area. Now, most people will tell you anywhere from 2 to 3 credit cards is just fine. Don't go out and keep applying for different credit cards trying to help your credit mix, because it only makes up 10% of your credit score. You can be too aggressive in one area and it may hurt your credit score. So it's good to have 2 or 3 credit cards, paying them on time and monthly, and even paying them off. When it comes to your auto loans, paying them on time, paying your medical loans on time, paying your student loans on time. Having a great mix of credit shows the credit score people, those Fair Isaac guys, that you know how to handle different types of credit, and you're being a good steward of your credit score. You're being a good steward in your finances. So when those lenders, those borrowers, they try to look at your credit score, they're like, wow, you have a 800 credit score. You're doing really well. Hey, you're in one of our top tier groups, so you can actually pick whatever loan you want for how much you want. Now, granted, you're only making like $50,000. You probably don't want to take out a loan for $150,000 unless you have a few people co-signing that they're going to be responsible for that loan too. Had nothing to do with it. But the point is this, it makes up 10% of your credit score. Okay, according to FICO. FICO actually, right, 90% of lenders look at your FICO score rather than your Vantage 3.0 score that was made up by the actual 3 credit agencies, TransUnion, Equifax, and Experian. Now, you probably want to go over to annualcredit.com to get your free annual credit report to see what's actually on your credit, to see if you have a good credit mix. Now, if you want to track your score, go over to Credit Karma, and they will track your Equifax and your TransUnion credit score. Now, granted, here's something that's good to know. Credit Karma actually generates your Vantage 3.0 score and not your FICO score. Now, through your bank or your credit union, they can actually pop up your FICO score for you, and some of them actually offer it for free. Like Navy Federal, they actually offer it for free, and some other financial institutions offer it for free. Now, the reason why I say go over to Credit Karma, even though it's the Vantage Score 3.0 and not the FICO, most times they're really close, anywhere 10 to 20 points. Now, if you're on the cusp of 620 and 630 and you're trying to buy a home, then you may want to actually get your FICO score. Now, here's another one. Even if your credit score is that low, I advise not getting a loan at this time, because your rates will be astronomical compared to somebody else. Now, your goal should be over 700, even though I said 720 is the golden ticket. But even when you hit 700, you raise it 70 points from that 630, your credit interest rate will go down for that particular loan, whether it be for a house or car or yacht. Anyway, but the point is this, you want that score to be over 720 to get those top tier interest rate, which are fairly low. We're talking about 1 to 2%. Sometimes zero interest, they give you all sorts of deal because they're like, you're a trustworthy person. So here's 0% for the first 2 years. And then after that, we're just gonna make it 1%. Cause guess what? We're making money all these other suckers out here coming in here with 630s and 500, we're going to give them a 12%. So where we don't make money on you because you're a good steward and we still want your business, we're going to make money off of them. So your credit mix means that you can handle all types of credit. So this new loan you're about to get, You can handle this, man. You got that 720, you got that 700, man, you good to go. So this is Ross World. Credit Mix makes up 10% of your credit score according to FICO. It's important that you go get your credit report from annualcreditreport.com. And my disclaimer, my disclosure, they don't pay me or give me anything to put them out there. It's just free. Okay. But nonetheless, this is Ross World. Go over and get your credit report and see how your credit mix is. And it may tell you why your credit score is where it's at. I'm out.